want, and I know I'm screaming. Guide me right, oh, I love. I put from myself for myself. I made you out for the rest of the rest. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalam ala rasulillah. First time ever in the history of the World Cup, Quran al-Karim, the Quran al-Azim is recited. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalam ala rasulillah. We should be proud of this, and we should be proud of what Qatar is doing. I will not talk on the difference between scholars, yani whether these football problems or anything. Now, this is the reality. The reality is that now the World Cup is held and we should seize the opportunity for da'wah. Over 600 converts, alhamdulillah, with the presence of Dr. Zakir Naik. Four people converted on the hands of Zakir Naik after the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something excellent, and this is something good for Muslims. People talk on it's an opportunity, and Qatar showed the world the real civilization of the Arabs. You know that the Arabs are powerful and they can do such and such. This is on one scale, on the one side of the scale. On the other side, which is more important, is the da'wah. Qatar, even they spent 200 billion money, but Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala converts through you one person, it is better for you than the red camels. And the red camels were the best money an Arab would own back then in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And alhamdulillah that even the coaches hear the adhan, the coach of England, the coach of Germany, the coaches, they hear the adhan and it will melt their hearts, because their hearts full of kufr, it will melt with the call of tawheed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And let there be arising from you a nation inviting to all that is good, and enjoying what is right, and forbidding what is wrong. And those among you will be the successful. Though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala urges us to do da'wah, brothers and sisters, and we thank Qatar for this for this host of this of the preachers, alhamdulillah, more than 6,000, I guess, or 2,000 preachers from all over the world. Even Sheikh Uthman Farooq is present in Qatar to make da'wah. This is an opportunity for people who understand the languages of the kuffar. And some people are afraid from this word. The word kafir, even Facebook banned it. It just means that you cover the truth. You have the truth in your heart, but when it is shown to you, let the Qatari people, let the preachers there tell them, and let us make opportunity for da'wah. I made two posts. They reached the whole world, the Australian Muslim. Alhamdulillah, on these blessed pages, I just did one or two pair of posts. They reached the whole world. Why? People are available for you. People are ready for truth. They are born on the instinct, but it's whether we seize the opportunity or not to do da'wah, ya ikhwani. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. You were the best of among the nations, spread da'wah, sent to people. So seize the opportunity and seize da'wah. We thank, as I said, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, you are the best nation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so everything is best in Islam, the best religion, the best prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best place in the world, Mecca, the best religion, Islam, the best of books, the revelation, everything is best. But it's not about this, brothers and sisters. It's all about da'wah. Someone saw Ibn Baz in his dream, and he said, advise me. He kept saying, do da'wah, do da'wah, do da'wah, more than 20 times, until the man woke up, and still Ibn Baz in his ear, he hear it in his ear that Ibn Baz saying to him, yani rahimahullah, do da'wah, make da'wah, make da'wah, make da'wah. Because this is what Qatar will take, what the Qatari authorities will take with them to their tombs. And not, if they hold million times a World Cup, if only one person is given the hidayah through you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you better than all Rolls Royce, better than all Lamborghinis and Ferraris and all what is on this world, better than all the 6 kilograms of gold of the World Cup. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you better than that. It equals 28 billion money. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more than that. The world has more than 6 kilograms of gold. The world has better than that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you better than diamonds and diamonds if one person is guided to you. This is an wake up call for the preachers all over the world to do da'wah. If you say only subhanallah, Muslim is blessed. If you say only subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, you have better than that. How about if one converts or reverts through you to Islam? Alhamdulillah for the bounty of Islam, alhamdulillah for the ni'mah of Islam. So those haters who used to target Qatar, now when they come to Qatar, they melt. They fall in love with Islam. They fall in love with the whole. Yani, subhanAllah, today, in the opening match, they go to each and every seat. They find cadeaus. They find gifts from Qatari people. They give them gifts, subhanAllah. Qatar does not need your money, actually. Just come and see the civilization of Islam, the generosity of Muslims. What is important is not civilization at the end of the time, at the end of the day, but the da'wah. This is what we will take with us to the tombs, ya ikhwani. Make them love Islam and make them love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as if he will be the best for them. I mean, this is what happened to Thumama ibn Athal, who was caught in the masjid, and he saw, because before he came to the Muslims, he used to have these stereotypes about Muslims. Hey, you Muslims, you are barbarians and you live in the desert. Now come, we show you what is the desert. Out of the stadium of Bayt al-Bayt, this is the first, why Qatar chose the Bayt, the stadium of the al-Bayt. It means it is our home. All humanity are one. But just this hatred that separates us. Come and we will show you. Come. We show you the civilization. Yes, we may live in the desert, but we may be better than you. Best money, best religion, best manners. Have you seen the hostness and the, subhanAllah, the manners of the Qatar people? Very generous, very soft people. That's why those four converted on the hands of Zakir Naik. And that's why more than 600 reverted. Or convert if not from the people of the book, but revert if he is or she is from the people of the book. They become Muslim. Why? Because they see now the manners and the soft manners of the Muslims. They hear the adhan. They hear the adhan in the training stadiums or pitches. And subhanAllah, it softens their hearts. It melts their hearts, their solid hearts because of kufr. And they will enter the masjids in Qatar. Thanks for Qatar for this da'wah. Let's be on Facebook, even we are not there. But let's spread the we do influence too, yani we do the influence through, let's be ambassadors and cavaliers of Islam actually. Let's show them the beauty of Islam, that a Muslim, the Muslim's words should be applied to applicable to his sayings, yani, and to his faith, and let's compare between our religion and their religion, comparative religion. That's why they bring Zakir Naik, alhamdulillah, Uthman Farooq, the guys are there, alhamdulillah, to do the job. Let's not judge others. Let's be neutral, but let's make them love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Let's seize the opportunity to talk on Sira, his life, his marriages, and his women and his children, and that a Muslim does not punish animals. Does not, if a Muslim does it, that's not Islam, and we should show them what is the real Islam. The Muslim does not hurt any preacher in his synagogue or in church, or does not harm any animal or tree or any or whatever. A Muslim has passion, has sympathy for the women, for the children, and for the elder. A Muslim obeys his parents and helps them. A Muslim does not kill the innocent. A Muslim does not cheat or do zina or drink wine or LGBT. And we should show them why LGBT, because it's against the fitrah. And then we should also tell them, you know what? Your body and your soul is not yours. You should tell them this. Your body in the World Cup. Yeah, if you are there and listening to me, your body and your soul are not yours, and that they are amana from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you should, and you will not taste the sweetness of happiness, of faith, until you follow Islam. A Muslim does not steal or lie, and so on and so forth. If you do one hasan, it's duplicated to 700. A Muslim helps the needy, the distressed, the poor, etc., etc. A Muslim does not accept oppression. A Muslim coexists with Muslims and non-Muslims, and there should be love. And you saw the first thing, Morgan and this Qatari handicapped guy, mashallah, who is very well known. They did a very good mission to humanity. This is Bayt al-Hikmah. It should be called this stadium, that it is Bayt al-Hikmah. And that Islam does not oppress women. Islam says you are born equal. This is the first thing that Omar wrote in the Constitution, and it's still up to date in the Constitution of America. If you open the book of the Constitution of America, the first sentence that you see is that people are born equal. From where did they take this? They take from Islam, of course. Alhamdulillah, you should teach them what is Quran, what is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Teach them the beauty of Islam, ikhwani, and that there is equality of in Islam. Islam is submission to the will of Allah. It's a way of life, not like in Christianity, not the way of life. Only believe, and that Islam is the only salvation, and not salvation through worshipping a man like you who has maybe it's depicted. This God is depicted in the Bible not as it should be. I will not say how God is depicted in the Bible. If you just read the Bible and read Quran, you will find the difference. Do not tell them, like, for example, that God in the Bible is depicted that he has seven eyes and he's a goat or a sheep. No, just don't attack them. Let them compare themselves. Read the Bible and read the Quran. And alhamdulillah, now they are distributing the books of Islam, and because they already have view on their Bible, how it depicts God and so on. So then tell them that everything is best in Islam. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Jazakumullah khair. I mean, in general, this is what is Islam all about. It's all about believing in one God, Allah, and singling him out for worship, that all our deeds must or should, if they are non-Muslim, should go up only to Allah, and that his deeds are done for us. We believe that he is the Khaliq, he is the Razik, he is the provider, and he is only him. No other shrine or saint or any or witch. We don't do all that stuff of shirk, and our deeds must go only to him, because he created us alone. If your body, your soul is owned by Allah, and if I give you a gift, would you thank my brother? Qatar now give you a gift, you will thank Jordan or Morocco? No, you will say thank you, Qatar. Thank you, Qatar, for giving us these gifts. And mashallah, you are generous. That's the same thing with Allah, and to Allah is the best example. Yani Allah gave you this mouth, this nose to inhale oxygen, these eyes that merit diamonds or more, and more, and this body, this soul, it's not yours. It's given to you by someone else, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you should worship Allah as He wants, not as human being wants, or your mind wants, or my mind wants. So this is generally, Qatar has succeeded to show the real message of Islam. And Qatar is open and coexistent at the same time. So all those stereotypes against Qatar were debunked at the very before the beginning of the World Cup, because Infantino and Cristiano Ronaldo and the other Ronaldo, all of them confessed and revealed that the best version ever of World Cup is Qatar. And why not? Everything is available. You pay only this card online. When you go there, everything for free. breakfast for free, transportation for free. What do you want else? Yani you go to America, half a billion. They lost. They paid half a billion for the World Cup. These are misers. You go to other countries, only 3 billion, 2 billion. But Qatar. Qatar. وما أدرك ما Qatar. What makes you know what is Qatar? They spent for you 220 billions of dollars just for you. Of course. For us and for them. For them, they will benefit infrastructure. The next generation will benefit. Yet, Qatar will gain nothing from this World Cup. They will gain only 200. They will gain only 2.2 billions. But they spent 200 billions. It's extraordinary, man. You can count it by trillions, as it were. What will Qatar gain? Only this. If they only banned LGBT. Why? No smoking and no vain talk, etc., etc. If only this. If only 1,000 convert to Islam, and inshallah it will reach 1,000, it's enough, alhamdulillah. Enough. Yani jazakumullah khair. Alhamdulillah, this is all I wanted to talk about in this session. That we are very, very, very happy. And you know this one. They built this is they call it their gafta or something, this hat. They built mashallah a stadium like this one. They call it gafta, I guess. It's Qalansuwa in Arabic. Yani they succeeded, alhamdulillah, showing the world what is Islam and what is the they will change the stereotype of the world that Qatar is yani desert or barbarian or anything. Now, alhamdulillah, succeeded, and the mission is still ongoing. We should make da'wah ourselves. For example, if we talk on our groups and our pages, you go, for example, to any organization of da'wah, you find only 3-4 people working active. Where are the others? This is a da'wah mission, and we should be responsible for da'wah. Da'wah is not fun, it's responsibility, as Sheikh Mohammed Hassan says. Jazakumullah khair, alhamdulillah, for the success of Islam and Muslims, and inshallah may Allah give us more. Barakallahu fikum, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.